Good afternoon. Still low? No, right.
Good afternoon.
So let's continue chapter 10. Okay? So the last class we discussed about an act. Which act? Sana? Juvenile Justice Act of 2000, right? Any problem, Meghna? Any problem with my voice? No, right. So we discussed about Juvenile Justice Act. There are two classification, or there are two categories of children. One is in conflict with law, another one is in need of care and protection. So what is in conflict with law, Meghna?
Those who violate the laws.
Yeah, those who violate the laws. Okay? Any crime, committed any crime. Yeah. Then in need of care and protection. Sana? In need of care and protection.
They need care and protection.
Yeah. Who?
Like street children.
Who are without any home. Yeah. Without any assistance. Or the runaway children, missing children, the street children, abandoned children. Yeah. And who live with a person who is unfit to take care of that particular child. Yeah. Another one, who are mentally or physically challenged. A child with mental problems or physically challenged person. Yeah. Or any kind of the person who suffer from any illness or incurable diseases like cancer. Yeah. Then who are abused, sexual abuse, illegal acts. Who are vulnerable to drug abuse, who are the victims of natural calamity, yeah? Then, who are likely to be abused for Then these include, am I audible? Yeah, these include abandoned, orphaned or trafficked children, yeah? Okay, those who are trafficked, orphans, abandoned children, those who are the victims of natural calamity, those who are vulnerable to drug abuse, yeah, who are abused, there are certain children who are abused, right, then incurable diseases, the children with incurable disease or mentally or physically challenged, who live with a person who is unfit to take care of that particular child, and who are without home, like runaway children, street children and all. Okay. So we provide care and protection for these children under the Juvenile Justice Act of 2000. Clear? Okay. So we already finished the needs of children. Yeah. Let's move on to the institutions, programs and initiatives for children. There are certain programs for helping children. Okay. So the first program that we already covered, that is our famous ICDS, right? Integrated Child Development Service. Sana, can you read?
Integrated Child Development Services, ICDS of the Government of India. It is the world's largest early childhood program which aims to meet the health, nutrition, stimulation and early learning or education needs of children below 6 years of age in an integrated manner so as to foster their development. The program offers health, nutrition and hygiene education to mothers, non-formal preschool education to children aged 3 to 6, supplementary feeding for all children below 6 years and pregnant and nursing mothers, growth monitoring and basic healthcare services such as immunization, vitamin A supplements. The program today covers over 41 million children These services are delivered in an integrated manner at the child care center named Anganwadi.
Okay. Actually, that's all about our ICDS. We already discussed this scheme. Yeah, the main aim of this ICDS to provide health, nutrition and hygiene, right? Health, nutrition and hygiene for children below 6 years of age. That is the main aim of ICDS, Integrated Child Development Service. So this is a service that provided by our government, Government of India. And this is the world's largest early childhood program. Okay, world's largest early childhood program, that is our Indian government ICDS program. Integrated Child Development Services. So they provide health, nutrition, as well as support services, hygiene, education. Yeah, please write these terms. Health, nutrition, hygiene. Health, nutrition, hygiene. Education to mothers. Health, nutrition, hygiene, education to mothers. These are the services provided by ICDS. Okay. Providing health, providing nutrition, providing hygiene, and educating the mothers. Non-formal preschool education, that is our Anganwadi facilities. Okay. Normal preschool education for children between 3 to 6. And supplementary feeding, which means providing food as well as nutrients, and also growth monitoring, health checkup, immunization, nursing. Yeah, providing food and care for the pregnant as well as lactating mothers, that is our nursing mothers. Both are same, nursing and lactating mothers. Yeah, they take care of their growth, weight. Yeah, we learned about referral services and all, right? Referral service, which means, what is referral service, Meghna?
If a sister or nurse is found, they will provide the facilities for...
They refer that children to another hospital, right? Other than this primary health center or urban health centers and all. Okay? Clear? So, the first program or first institution in India to take care children, that is our ICDS program. Okay, ICDS program, that is the first program that operating in India, and this is the world's largest program for children. Okay, so they provide education, they provide nutrients or nutrition, then proper health, growth monitoring is there, then take care of mothers as well as lactating mothers, then referral services. All these are the certain services provided by the program ICDS, yeah, through Anganwadi. Yeah, that is also important. This is the largest program for children. Clear? Okay, so the next program, that is SOS. Okay, SOS program, another program to help our children, that is SOS. SOS Children Villages. I'll show a video. Okay. What is this SOS and all? Meghna, can you read?
This is an independent, non-governmental social organization which has beyond a family approach to the long-term care of orphan and abandoned children. SOS Villages have the vision of providing family-based long-term care to children who can no longer grow with their biological families.
Right. So, SOS Children's Village, it is entirely different from the orphans, or means orphan schools and all, orphanages and all. Okay, which means here in this SOS Village, they provide a family-based environment for children. Okay, they provide a family-based environment for children with brothers, with sisters, with a mother and all. Okay, working as a mother. Okay. So this is not a government organization, this is a non-governmental social organization. Okay, our ICDS is a government project, this SOS is a non-governmental organization. So we provide a family-based approach or family-based care to this orphan children or the abandoned children. Clear? So in each SOS home, there are number of SOS villages in our India and also in Kerala. In each SOS home, there is a mother who look after 10 to 15 children. Okay. So this SOS village is more about a family-based technique to care and educate the children. So there is a mother to care all these children. Yeah, 10 to 15 children are there with the mother. Okay, that is a family-based environment. It's entirely different from orphanage, right? 10 to 15 children under one mother. So this unit lives like a family, just like as a family, this unit, this SOS village lives like a family. And children experience relationships. So what is the main advantage of this SOS village? Because the children can experience relationship and love, right? And it is also help to recover them from this traumatic experience and all. They can easily avoid or they can easily recover from all those bad experiences in their life. Because they are having a mother, they are providing the love, care and all. Right now? Yeah. So this SOS families live together. All the SOS families live together and they form a supportive village environment. Okay, so the first SOS village was set up in 1964. Okay, first SOS village was set up in 1964. That year is very important. So the first program for children, that is ICDS service or ICDS program, the second program, that is SOS village or the SOS children's village. Okay, so in this SOS children village, there is a mother who take care 10 to 15 children. It's like a family based atmosphere. Okay, they provide love, care and all, just like as a family, just like as our family. Okay, they provide support. Clear? So second program. Okay, you're going to watch a video of this SOS village. Okay, so write down the key terms and all, key points. Just a minute. Reina, can you share? Can you share your views regarding the video? Can't hear you, dear.
It's kind of a very family-based.
Family-like environment, right? Entirely different from this orphanage.
An orphanage one.
With the mother, right? They are growing with the like mother. A family with brothers, sisters, a mother. Mother who take care of 10 children. Yeah? Just imagine.
Yeah. This is still there, ma'am.
Reina?
SOS and all still there?
Yes. Yeah. You can refer in Google, okay? SOS villages in India, SOS villages in Kerala. You just refer. Yeah, don't forget about the assignments. The list of needs of children, youth and elderly. That is an assignment, okay? I think it's clear about this SOS village, right? Yeah. So the first SOS village was set up in 1964, please note. The first SOS village was set up in 1964. Okay. So let's move on to the observation homes. Yeah. Reina, can you read? Read slowly, okay?
A observation homes where children stay temporarily till the completion of the investigation to track down their parents and collect information on their family background.
Okay, so first home for children, that is observation home. Okay, first home, that is observation home. So this is a temporary based home. Okay, it's not permanent, it's a temporary stay for children from 3 to 18 years, which means below 18 years, yeah, during the time of investigation or during the time of inquiry or enquiry. Okay, that is observation home. This is a children, they stay temporary in an institution, yeah, until this investigation gets over. Okay, observation home or during the time of enquiry. Temporary observation home. All these observation homes, special homes, juvenile homes, all these homes are for children below 18 years. Okay. Juvenile. Word meaning of juvenile, Reina?
Children.
That's it. Children or child. Okay. Juvenile delinquency, Meghna? Conflict with law, right? So this is our first home for children, observation home. Next one, yeah. Read, Reina. Special homes.
Special homes where juveniles, children under 18 years of age, found guilty in terms of violation of law, are placed in custodial care.
Yeah, okay. So a young person, a child is sent to jail when a child committed a crime. That's it. That is a special homes. Okay. Special homes. They are placed in the custodial care under the 18 years of age because they violate the law. That is the reason. Special home.
Ma'am, this is juvenile jail, right?
Reina?
Ma'am, this is juvenile jail?
Yeah, yes. Then, juvenile or children's home, another. Okay, this juvenile homes and juvenile jail, that is different, okay? Juvenile home just means children's home. Yeah. Sana, can you read?
Juvenile or children's homes were children whose families are not traceable or are unfit or dead or simply unwilling to take the child back stay. The government is responsible for providing room, board, education and vocational training.
So, there are certain parents, they are unwilling to take that particular child to their home back. Okay. So, the government need to provide assistance for that children, providing education, providing care as well as room, shelter for them. Okay. That is this children home and or juvenile home. Okay. Both are same, juvenile home. So, children homes. Sometimes it can be due to death of that family members or family due to any kind of natural calamities and all. Otherwise, a person is unfit to take care of that particular child. Otherwise, simply unwilling to take that child. All these matters, okay? So the government need to provide assistance to support the child, to support that child. Okay. So most of these homes are run by government in partnership with NGO. NGO means non-governmental organization. Okay. It's not directly the government project. All these homes are, most of the homes are run with the partnership of this NGO. Okay. So special home, observation home, children's home. Then we discussed about ICDS and SOS village. This SOS village is very important. Okay. Yeah. So another concept that is very important. This is the last concept under the vulnerability. Children. Okay. Children as a vulnerable group. The last point, that is adoption. adoption. Meghna, can you read?
Adoption. India has a long tradition of child adoption. Earlier, adoption was limited within the family and was covered by social and religious practices. But changing times, adoption beyond the family has been institutionalized and legalized. While the government of India and state governments provide necessary support and guidance through policies and programs, non-governmental organizations, NGOs, provide necessary delivery items, systems for the process of adoption. In order to strengthen adoption rules and facilitate adoption, the government of India, under the advice of the Supreme Court, has constituted a central agency, Central Adoption Resource Agency, CARA, to set up guidelines for adoption to safeguard the welfare and rights of children.
Which means earlier times, this adoption is only limited. Which means earlier times, adoption was only limited to the family. Yeah, from one family to another family and all. But now it's legalized and institutionalized under this agency, Central Adoption Resource Agency. If you are planning to adopt a child, you need to register in this agency, CARA. And they are the responsible person. They are the responsible institution for the adoption. Clear? It's CARA, okay? Central Adoption Resource Agency, CARA. So this CARA that provides all the guidelines, all the rules behind this adoption of that child, okay? Clear? CARA. So this is a central agency, not the NGO and all. It's a central agency, Central Adoption Resource Agency, CARA. This is very important. This SOS and CARA is important. Central Adoption Resource Agency. So the main objective of this agency is to put forward the laws, rights and guidelines for the adoption, for the child's adoption. Clear? Some technical issues. Yeah. Meghna, Raina, Sana, any doubts? No, right? Okay. This is about your practicals, okay? Is the screen visible? Meghna?
Yes, ma'am.
Just have a look, okay? For your practicals, okay? Evaluation of labels. You have to collect 5 labels brand name, logo, trademark, and include all these things. Ingredients, standardization mark given or not, standardized marking, which is a standard marking, expiry date, manufacturing date, quantity of pack, 60 gram, 150 gram and all. Okay? Clear, Reina? Okay? Is the screen visible, right? Yeah, like this you have to stick the labels. Okay, this is a label of Milky Bar and Perk. Fine, Meghna? I'll give a model for evaluation of this labels. You have to write. Let's take your notes. Ready? Agna? Right. This is just an example, okay? The label selected were chocolates. The label selected were chocolates. So the label selected were dairy products or cereal products and all. Okay. The label selected were chocolates. Each chocolate was branded. I'll read. Okay. You just mark the key points. Each chocolate was branded. Every chocolate was provided with nutritional information, quality information. Each brand has given its trademark, quality, batch number, manufacture expiry date were given. Then all branders show their FSSAI mark, except the fourth brand, that is Milky Bar. You have to compare if there is any. Then price and ingredients were shown at their label address, and instruction for storage was given. Made in India and barcode was given in all brands. This is an example or the model how to write the evaluation of each label. Okay. As a conclusion, you have to write the evaluation of each label, okay? And also include the packaging materials. Is it Spectra packaging or paper packaging and all, okay? Like a paragraph, like this, you have to write, okay? Any doubts, Reina? Sana, any doubts from chapter 10? No, right. So we'll meet in the next class. Thank you.
Thank you.